Today we're going to talk about what to do if you get pulled over with a CCW. Thanks for joining us again on Shoot of the Series. My name is Ed Thorell from Firearms Education and Training, and we want to thank all of our followers here on YouTube. If you haven't done it already, hit the like, hit the share, and also hit the bell so you get immediate notifications of brand new videos. You can also find us on all the normal social media, including Patreon and brand new to Parler as well. So anyway, today we wanted to take a few minutes to talk about a subject that keeps coming up. What to do if you've got a CCW and you happen to get pulled over. And it's something you need to be very careful about because you've got a heightened risk if you've got a firearm in the car. And we want to make sure everybody in our community stays safe. So the first place to start is by being smart about it. Make sure, first of all, that you've got all your documentation up to speed. Your driver's license is current. The tags are all current. The other thing is also do a walk around of your car to make sure that you don't have any, you know, blown out headlights, blinkers that don't work. These are all invitations to getting stopped by a cop, which if you can avoid is the best thing to do. If you get into the actual physical act, though, where you see the red and blue lights come up behind you, you want to go through a very simple but deliberate process to make sure that both you and the police officer remain safe. So first of all, pull over in a safe place, turn on your emergency blinkers. Also, roll your windows down so the cop can see throughout your car, nothing to hide. And also keep your hands on the steering wheel at the classic 10 and 2 position. If you've got passengers in the car, tell them not to be making any sudden moves and to keep all of their hands in view as well. In our particular county, one of the conditions for having a CCW is that you have to announce and disclose that. So talking to my friends that are CCW, talking to my friends that are police officers, they've all kind of come to a consensus that the first thing you should do is basically be polite, smile, show that you're not a threat. And then, you know, while your hands are on the wheel, announce to the cop, for your safety as well as mine, I'm required to let you know that I have a concealed permit and I have a firearm in the car. How would you like me to proceed from here? And then leave it up to the officer. They'll probably ask you, okay, what have you got and where do you have it? If you're carrying it, you know, on your waistband, you might say, hey, I've got it at my 4 o'clock position, and how would you like me to proceed? And then wait for the police officer to give you directions. You know, I carry my wallet on the left-hand side just because it's more comfortable, but also so that, you know, I'm not reaching for my right where, you know, there might be a pistol. So wait for the officer, pull out your wallet when told, and then hand him the ID that he's going to need to see, your CCW, your driver's license, your registration, and hand to him and put your hands back on the 10 and 2 position and wait. Don't make any sudden or furtive gestures because that's going to throw him off guard, and we don't need the officers to be at a heightened level where you might put yourself in danger. Now, if you get stopped at night, really important, turn on the dome light so that the officer can see everything that's happening in the vehicle. That's going to help put them at ease also. Something to think about also is many patrol cars and many agencies actually send out their officers as a single officer in a particular unit or your car. If you see two officers in a car, that could very well mean that what you're looking at is a training situation where you've got a training officer and then a new police officer who's being broken in. If something like that should happen, you might get a more close check than you would if it's a single officer, in that they might turn it into a training day and a training exercise where, you know, they might pull you out of the car handcuff you, sit you down on the curb so that the trainee can get the full experience of what they need to do with a suspicious traffic stop. Traffic stops are the most dangerous things that cops encounter and the number one thing where they get hurt, injured, or killed. So because of that, if you see two cops, you might expect that this might take a little bit longer and you may end up as a training exercise. Not to be alarmed, but you know, realize that you're going to be making their lives easier if you just go along with the process, settle in, realize that you're probably going to be there a while. Other steps that you can take are, you know, just to be friendly. Smile. These are all signs that you're not a threat. And just be careful with what you do and be very deliberate. Anyway, we hope this answers some of your questions on some of the do's and the don'ts. And we hope this helps out for those of you that are in the EDC community that are wondering what you have to do. So on behalf of Shoot of the Series and from Firearms Education Training, I'm Ed Thorell. We appreciate you watching. Y'all take care.